And gentlemen, it's a pleasure to see you all. Yes, Ahmedabadma investment namnu koi aave to, there is always a good audience. It's nice. We should be proud of it. There's nothing wrong. It's very good. So thank you for, as I always say, investing your time. You'll get a good ROI. And it's a pleasure. It's you all know the topic, so I won't dwell upon that much and leave it that to the expert. But in the past, Dr. Jatin Pancholi has addressed different program at AMA. He's based in the UK, but when I was in Ahmedabad, he was a faculty here, and he has kept, as he rightly says, has an emotional bond with AMA. So he and even his colleague, Dr. Pauro Shukla, who often comes here, and they've even addressed gatherings in a pairs. But today this topic is his forte, being a man of finance. So for the benefit of a lot of people who have not heard him before, and otherwise also, I'll give a brief introduction about Dr. Jatin Pancholi before we begin this. Dr. Jatin Pancholi works as a faculty member at the Middlesex University, London in the UK, and he teaches accounting and finance for MBA program. And for your information, the Middlesex University is ranked in the top 4% of the world's universities in management. And of course, he was very much from Ahmedabad before, and by training is a first class commerce graduate, MBA gold medalist, finance specialization, and a PhD in finance. And I was just talking to him, academics is in his DNA. His father was also a renowned professor of economics. And he has also a diploma in TQM and ISO 9000. And he has undertakes management consulting and corporate training assignments in the areas of cost management, measuring business performance, balanced scorecard, activity-based costing management, financial management, leadership and strategic management. So he's committing a gamut of topics, and since he's based in UK, he has wonderful clients that include Microsoft, Google, who have taken advantage of his trainings, you know, London Islington Council, Churchill Insurance, TCS, Jindal Southwest, ICICI Bank, they're his customers. And he has, to his credit, various research papers published in different journals, and he addresses a lot of seminars and gatherings of this style. He's one of the most sought after speakers and invited as a keynote speaker in many international conferences and symposium. He has taught more than 16,000 graduate and PG and PhD students from more than 50 countries worldwide. And as I said, he has a lot of done publication, and regarding professional memberships, he has several memberships. I won't go through all of these because we want to take more benefit of his time. But these include the Finance Management Association International USA and the Association of Accounting and Business Affairs UK. And besides his passion for numbers and economics and figures, he has other hobbies, interestingly, like astronomy, photography, blogging, travel, optical illusion, piano, and poetry. So I think next time with your figures, we will also like a piano concert or a poetry, which will be a good blend. And of course, astronomy, you'll be showing us the stars at night, but at least you'll not be showing the stars in the daytime, that's for sure, you know. But that's on the lighter side. And it's a pleasure to have you again. And on behalf of the audience, ANMA, it's a pleasure to welcome you, and I'll welcome you with a bouquet of flowers, Jatin. His talk and presentation will be approximately 1 hour, and we will have a 15 or 20 minute Q&A session. And while I request that, let those questions be very short and crisp, because sometimes the questions run into four lines. At the end of the line, you don't realize what is your question. And that will give more benefit to others, so that we have a variety of questions. So over to you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes, very, very good evening, all of you. Are you all okay? Yes. Good, good. First of all, I should be apologizing to all of you. We started a few minutes late. So sometimes, you know, good things take little time to get it. So what we want to do, I'm going to time my presentation. The plan for today is to give you some idea about the topic, of course, and also share with you my own experience in the field of stock market. How many of you have read any yellow color newspaper? Yellow color newspaper? Pink? Okay, pink. Pink is also fine. So you have been reading yellow and pink color newspaper. And when I looked at that newspaper a few years ago, especially, you know, we have a habit of reading newspaper from the backside. And I had a nightmare on that day. There were so tiny numbers on the back of the newspaper, and so many of them. And then I was thinking, oh, I need to memorize it to be able to become an intelligent person. And that was the biggest shock of my life. How many of you have experienced that shock before? Looking at the last section, last few pages of a pink newspaper, right? It is very shocking. So what I'm going to do now is, the agenda for today we have for next 1 hour or so is, of course, what is stock market, but more importantly, I also want to touch upon what is not stock market. Because what I've noticed is that many people know many things about stock market, but whatever they know, they have wrong information. So I'm going to deal with today some of the myths or misunderstandings that we have. Even I used to have a lot of misunderstandings. So what is not stock market? And of course, I'm going to discuss with you principles of savings and investments, a sustainable strategy. And I'm also going to share with you about a little more detailed 3-evening training program that Ahmedabad Management Association has planned, which is on April 9th to 11th. So before, and of course, then I will take 15, 20 minutes question and answer. So before I start, I would acknowledge Mr. Radia sir, who has kindly introduced me and hosted me for today. And he and I, we have been exchanging conversations in several years. And he and other dignitaries in Ahmedabad Management Association, they have been tremendously developing the organization in big time. And of course, my gratitude goes to my KK Nair sir, who is also one of the strong pillars who is able to organize a lot of events. So with that, I would like to make some request. No mobile phone, please. Okay, if you want, you can have audio recording of the discussion, but try to be away from Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp for a few minutes. Is that okay? Very difficult, isn't it? And entry exit, you know what happens? Is that okay? So entry exit, lot of problems. You know, sometimes, you know, we have a discussion going on and people coming in, people going out. And my favorite color is red. Somebody's red is going out. My eyes are going following him or her. And then I lost my attention. So after 45 minutes, I restarted the presentation. So I hope you don't want me to. Is that okay? So whatever I'm discussing today, do not resist the new ideas. Just have trust and faith and implement those ideas for next 100 days. Can you all do that? See, how can you decide whether this idea is good or bad unless you don't implement it? So implement these ideas, apply these ideas for next 100 days. 100 days is a good trial room wherein you can decide whether these ideas can work for you or not. And any question comes into your mind, if any of my slide has got any word which you don't understand, any specific word, you can raise your hand, interrupt me, and ask me the meaning, I'm going to explain. But if you have a more specific question, it's a good idea we keep the questions at the end. And again, more specific question. And if you want to have any other interaction with me, I'll try to stay for some more time after we finish. Okay? So that's the plan. What I want to propose to you is understand, first of all, is what is a stock market? Right? Now, stock market is basically where buyers and sellers are meeting together. There is a buyer who wants to buy something, seller who wants to sell something. And started in the year 1602. The bull that you see in the photograph is, the photograph is clicked by myself in the world's oldest and world's first stock exchange in Amsterdam, not in Bombay Stock Exchange, right? Or not in New York Stock Exchange. And the concept we need to understand is the whole idea of stock market is efficient use of resources. Now, if I may ask you, how many of you, hand on your heart, be honest to yourself, how many of you are scared of stock market? Scared, very good. I like honest people, very nice. Scared, right? Very good. And how many of you hate stock market. Now there's a different emotion, being scared and being emotion, and being hating. Good. So if I ask you a question, saving money, is it a good habit or is it a bad habit? Good habit? Yes or no? Good habit? Now imagine if this whole room or whole hall is a one country, one economy. And everybody in this country saves their 100% of money. What will happen? Sorry? Country will not grow. So savings is a virtue individually, but for the society, savings is a vice or a bad habit. So the point is, the capital of the country or economy has to grow. And how can that happen? It can happen only if individually a family's income is growing. Make sense? Now just imagine you're looking from the viewpoint of political agenda of growing economy by 5%, 10%, and considering what politicians can do for me, how political ideologies are helping me for my benefit. But the reverse is true. If every family sitting in this hall, every individual sitting in this hall, make a determination that 2018, 2019, I'm being told that financial year is just starting, am I right? When is it starting? After 2 days. It's a new financial year, 1st April, right? Can we increase our income by 10%? Just imagine what will happen if every family in the country, in India to be specific, increase their family income by 10%. Every family. What will happen? Inflation will increase. But what will happen to the national economy, GDP? The entire, sorry? GDP will increase. Excellent. Very good. Right? So the whole country will grow by 10%. Now these people didn't look at my slide of entry and exit, so we can't say anything. Please have a seat. Be comfortable. So always understand, stock market is a platform to make the capital formation. If there is no stock market happening in economy, the economy will not grow. So either we could be scared of stock market, we could be hating stock market. It is a lifeblood of an economy, started since 1602. But then there are so many myths about the stock market, as I said. A lot of people have misunderstanding. So what I want to clarify to all of you is stock market is not a gamble. It's not a speculation that you do trial and error. And it is certainly not based on luck. How many of you think stock market depends upon luck? Anyone? Yeah? Partly yes. So this is what we need to understand. Is the luck, what is the meaning of luck? What is the meaning of luck? By chance.
God's grace.
Right time, right place. Getting the benefit. Luck, according to my mentor, is opportunity plus preparation. Opportunity plus preparation. If there is no opportunity, you cannot be lucky. If there could be an opportunity, but you don't have preparation, you are not prepared for it, you are not lucky. What I'm trying to convey, stock market is not difficult. Or making profit and sustaining profit is not difficult. But remember one thing, stock market is not a quick, rich scheme. I got some of my friends, who would ask me, okay, JP, tell me, what should I invest? Where should I invest? I said, do this, do that. After 2 months, he's going to call me and say, this money is not growing. He said, 2 months, it's not a quick, rich scheme. You have to wait. Right? So do not expect short-term results. And one more clarification I want to give you here is stock market do not need any specific education qualification. It doesn't require any talent. Anyone having talent, lot of talent? Any talented person in the room? Yeah? Welcome. But stock market doesn't require talent. If you have it, it's bonus, but you don't need it. And stock market doesn't require mathematical mind.
We are all are talented.
All are talented, very good.
Stock market doesn't require mathematical mind. Right? How many of you think that you are not good in numbers? How many of you think I'm not good in numbers? Right from school, college, childhood, our parents, oh, you are not good in numbers. Have you been told like that? Have you heard from teachers, parents, society, family, you are not good in numbers? Isaac Newton was told the same thing. Right? And you know what happened to Isaac Newton in his life. So what I'm trying to convey is, do not keep it in your mind, okay, I need this. No. All what you need is openness and willingness to learn and work hard on it. This whole concept of investment works on principles, scientific principles. I'm going to share with you 5 of those principles today. Is that okay? And I'm going to give you 100 days homework. Can I give you homework? Will you do it? After 100 days, I'm going to ask you, have you done the homework or not? Is that okay? These are the principles of savings. Unless and until we don't understand the principles of savings, nothing is going to work. Remember, one thing is monthly cash flow. How many of you have a monthly cash flow statement made in your home, in your family? I'm not talking about your shop. I'm not talking about your business. I'm not asking you about monthly cash flow of your factory. I'm asking monthly cash flow of your family. How many? Please raise hand straight. And those who are not raising hand, can you look at around? How many of them? Can you just see? In a room of how many people must be there approximately in the room? 250, 300. I can see about 8 or 10 hands raised. Very good. Thank you. Yeah? Yes, sir.
Yeah, I do it.
You are there as well. Okay, we say, okay, 10, 12, 15. Imagine out of a room of 250 people, 15 people raise the hand that they do have monthly cash inflow. Can somebody champion in mathematics without open up your mobile phone, without opening your mobile phone? How much is the 15 as a percentage of 250?
20%?
No, 20% will be 30. 7? Wow. Very good, decimal points. So 7% you said?
37.
15 is not 37% of 250. It has to be less than 10%. 7%, 8. 7, 8%. Just imagine. And this is the most advanced and illustrious crowd of investor alert people in the most adventurous city of the most developing, fast developing country in the world. Just imagine what is the situation in other cities, other countries. Right? And then we say, "Arey, share bazar mein to koi agalad nahi aavta." Have you heard that? "Arey, small investor to fasai jai chhe." Have you heard about that? See, the point is, we need to understand is first is to have a correct nail in the hammer and dig it well is a monthly cash flow. And obviously, monthly cash flow will translate into yearly cash flow. The real challenge is to balance between income and expenditure. So many people in the Western world, I'm giving example of Western world, if you go towards east side, from Turkey is all Eastern world. If you go towards west side from Turkey is Western world, if you draw a line on the world's map, right? In the Western world, which means from Turkey towards this side, all the countries, they have expenses more than incomes.
Credit cards.
And now, because we are following Western fashion, Western clothes, Western mobile phones, right? Western laptops, we have now Western credit cards. In fact, original Indian culture, or if I say Indus Valley civilization culture, which I also include Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, all these belt, borrowing money is an insult. Today, borrowing money is big prestige. Higher you borrow, bigger you are. I don't want to look at newspapers. I don't want to give you those examples because you are already tired these examples, 24 hours TV channels and newspapers, right? So I don't want to touch upon that, but I hope you got my message. Now, do we want to become like that? Or do we want to establish a better financial position? Who are our role models? Whom are we copying? What is our purpose? These are the questions we need to ask ourselves. So balancing is crucial and very important because in my life, I have been learning myself from various financial management experts and who are experts not only in terms of money, but also successful in life, in terms of happiness, health, relationship, and many other aspects. And I have picked and chosen some of the billionaire mentors who are guiding me and helping me to understand and to change my thinking. So what I'm going to do today and also during 9 to 11 April is I'm going to translate and transfer that knowledge and thought process to all of you. Is that okay? One of the point is difference between expense and asset. Do we have a laser light here? Would I press it? Yeah. What is the difference between expense and asset? Expenses and assets. Yes, sir.
Buying a jewelry for wife is expense. It is not expense, it is asset.
Buying a
jewelry for
wife. Wow. Thank God my wife is not here today. It's an asset. Okay. How do you distinguish? Yes, Manu?
Asset is?
General revenue. Very good. Always, yes, sir.
Anything going out of pocket is expense. Anything coming inside the pocket is asset.
Very good. Coming inside and outside pocket. Excellent. That's a good way of looking at it. Asset means anything which will give you future income. And expense is anything which is gone forever. Right? Now my question to you, look at your monthly cash inflow statement and identify where are you spending money? Is it an expense or is it an asset? Can you do that? This is your first homework. Next 100 days, look at every money that you spend and then decide yourself, is it E for expense or is it A for assets? Can you all do that? For example, you pay money for taxi. What is it? You buy a car. You buy a car. Tricky. You buy a car on loan. You buy a car on loan. It's an expense, and not only expense, it's a liability because you have to pay loan for next 3 years. Right? But if you buy a house, if you buy property, you buy gold, you buy jewelry, you buy shares, stock market, what is it?
Assets.
Ask yourself, every time you pay money out, go home and distinguish, did I spend this money for expenses or asset? The problem is our eyes and ears and brain is absorbing information from outside world. Yes or no? Every time we open up a newspaper, every time we watch TV channel, all what they're talking to us is about what? E or A? What are they talking about? Film celebrities come up on TV or newspaper, advertise. What do they talk about? Expenses. Everybody wants a share of expenses from your pocket. Now it's up to you. Do you want the same mobile phone that Hrithik Roshan is using? Or where do you want to invest your money? So first point is to prioritize what you want to do. And remember, principle of postponing short-term pleasure that do not add value in your life. In fact, there is a principle called principle of delayed gratification. If you want to write down, principle of delayed gratification. Unfortunately, currently the generation is Maggie generation, Maggie noodle generation, 2 minutes. We want to invest money and when do we want it back? 2 minutes. That doesn't happen. That happens in Maggi noodles. Doesn't happen in stock market or investment. Always remember to postpone your short-term pleasures that do not add value. Identify what are your short-term pleasures that doesn't add up any value. Delayed gratification. Whatever you delay to have it, whenever you get in a better quality. Principle of delayed gratification. So this is one of the examples I want to share with you, which personally I'm doing it myself, and I'm guiding every single client to whom I'm meeting, every single friend or family or anybody who wants to know anything from me. This is the sample I give them. This is your homework number two. What was your homework number one? Yeah? I hope you are making notes. Your homework number two, next 100 days, make this statement. And this PowerPoint file is not going to be available to you in printed format. So you better copy it. I know expert people are taking photograph. Most welcome. You can take a photo. Or maybe if AMS has got a WhatsApp group, they can put this photo. I have no problem. But point is, this is the template we need to follow for next 100 days. First thing, what we write is income. Yes or no? Because that's where money coming in. Remember one thing, either you are in stock market, you are in property market, gold market, silver market, anything. First, you are a human being. Do you agree? Human being? And we are on the planet Earth. Blue ball. How many planets are in the world? How many satellite objects are in the world? And how many human beings on the planet Earth? We need to be thankful to the God, to the Creator, that the God, the Creator, the Almighty gave us income. And we are on this planet, this Earth, not just because we are smart. We didn't choose our parents. Anybody made a choice of their parents? Anyone? Nobody choose their parents. Nobody choose their brothers and sisters. Did we make a choice which family we will be born, which area we will be living? This is the whole concept of spiritual science. Unless we don't understand the principles of spiritual science, nothing is going to work. No stock market, no wealth, nothing is going to work. And the world, the planet Earth has given us so many things. Our family has given us so many things. Our surrounding has given so many things. The God or Almighty or superpower, whatever label you have fixed, that label has given you so many things. Do you agree? Yes or no? Do you know people who are poorer than you? Anyone? Do you know people who are poorer than you? Do you know people who got half income than you have? Do you know people who got 1/10 of income than you have? But see, you are lucky. You are blessed. Because the society, the world, the God, your family, they have done a lot of investment in you so far. Your first duty is to return to them. The moment you get income, the first money you take it out is for donation and charities. If you don't do donations and charities, it's not going to work. This is the sequence we need to follow. Next 100 days, can you all do that? Now, I'm not going to ask you the amount. You decide the amount. I'm not going to tell you where you should donate, where you should do charity. It's your choice. Whatever you like, whatever you love, whatever is core to your heart, whatever excites you, whatever purpose makes you emotional, that purpose we all need to do donation and charity. I'm not asking you right now whether you agree with this or not. What I'm telling you is, next 100 days, can we all follow this? And after 100 days, you decide whether you want to continue or not. Have you been to any tailor's place? You're having a suit or jacket or something. You go to trial room for a few minutes, see whether it works for you or not, and then you come out. Consider that 100 days is a trial room for you. Try out this for 100 days. If it is too tight for you, we can always loosen it. If it is too loose for you, we can tighten it up. We can make changes after 100 days. Is that okay? Most important, donation and charity. And after whatever money is left, the second you are taking money out is for savings and investments. Why most of the people have very poor investment strategy? Because they first have income, then they have EMIs going. EMI for car, EMI for mobile, EMI for house and whatnot. And whatever is left, go for a holiday. Gentleman was saying, buy some jewelry. So now what is left? Nothing. So what is investment? Nothing. Unless the income tax department forces you that if you do investment, you get some tax exemption. Am I right? Wrong. Whole science is done wrong way. This is the format. First is income. Second is? Whatever money. See, I'm not going to tell you about money. You are all adult, mature people. Anybody below 18 years of age in the hall? All above 18? Oh, we got someone below 18? Very good. So legally, you need to check with your family, right? Because you need to have a legal backing to take your decisions. After whatever is left from donation charity, you need to have investments and savings. Generally, all over the world, one of my another gurus to whom I am following and reading their work is Warren Buffett. How much percentage of investment you should make every month out of your income? How much? 20? 30? Well, all over the world it is said, if you do minimum, 15% of your savings, 15% of your total income as your savings and investments. Minimum. 15%. Can you all do that? Every month. And now whatever is left, that becomes your lifestyle. Now you spend money. But 90% of the population, I'm not going to do a survey right now. I don't want to ask you embarrassing questions. 90% of you right now sitting in the hall, they do this at the first. And no space for donation charity. Donation charity? Aray, Baba, I want donation and charity. Yes or no? What donation charity? Charity begins from home, my home. English phrase, right? I'll just take some water. So this is the most important. Can you all do this for next 100 days? Principles of investment, very important. Identify your life's purpose. Identify your life's dreams and goals. Should you put all your eggs in one basket? Or not? Obviously, no. Now, within your 15%, have a breakup. Where do you want to invest? Where do you want to save money? Don't just run after the tax man. Don't just run after the tax rules and regulations. I'm mindful of the time. So do research. Unless you don't research, nothing is going to work. And in stock market, you know what's the easiest method? Oh, I've got some tip. Have you heard that? Oh, my friend has given me a tip to invest in Bajaj Auto, in Honda, in TCS. Tip. I thought tip you give only in the restaurants to waiters who serve. So who is a waiter here? Who is giving tip to whom? And the stock market investor who is dependent upon the tip of somebody else, where is that person bringing the tip from? What is this tip business? Can we make tips illegal? Why tips? Why not education? Why not research? Why not understand the concept of research? Charlie Munger, have you heard the name Charlie Munger? Charlie Munger is the brain behind Warren Buffett. He never comes on TV, newspaper, nobody. He is aged 92 years of age, right? Now Warren Buffett's all investments, all strategies is decided by Charlie Munger. What Charlie Munger does, and Warren Buffett himself, both of them together, 8 to 10 hours a day, the only thing they do is research. They read about the company, they read about the industry, they read about the country, they look at their balance sheet, profit and loss account, cash flow statement. I know these words may be French for you, some of you, but don't worry, I'm going to deal with that. So most important is research. And the principle of elimination. You don't need 20 transactions a month to become an investor. You need 20 good transactions in your lifetime. That's it. You don't need every day trading. You don't need to become a trader. I'm referring as a stock market as an investment. All you need is a 20 good transactions in your lifetime. You don't need every day, oh, I'm going to buy something, I'm going to sell something. If you want to become a trader by choice, it's up to you. It's a great profession, right? No problem. But I'm right now focusing on stock market as an investment and not as a trading. Is that okay? Yeah? Because traders would have different requirements because they have to deal whole thing as a business. They have to have their own customers. They have to satisfy them. It's a little bit different science. So principle of elimination. Elimination is how do you eliminate companies one by one? You take list of 30, Bombay Stock Exchange, 30 companies. Out of 30, how do you narrow down to one company that you want? Right? And build your risk profile. Your risk profile may be different based on your age bracket, may be different based on your marital status. It may be different based on your current assets. If you are already at a middle-aged person or a retired person, you don't want to take risk and you don't want to put all your money in something fishy. Similarly, even if you're young, you don't want to put all your money in one basket, but at the same time, you can take a little bit risk and that risk can be spread across a number of years. So build your risk profile. Right? So point is, what I'm sharing with you all now is sustainable strategy for investment. Tips don't last. If you love tips, if you like getting tips, maybe the April 9th to 11th workshop is not for you. Clear? No confusion. If you love tips, if you like tips, and if you only want to live your life based on tips, there's no need. But if you want to do your research, if you want to do learning, and if you want to become champion, master for this, then only the workshop is for that. We need to balance sustainable strategy. Making 20% profit per year or 50% profit per year, first time, second time is easy. But can you sustain it for year after year after year? What is your return on investment, ROI? And for how many years you can keep making it, keep making it, keep making it. That's the point. And that is where I'm sharing with principles which I have researched myself and I'm presenting in front of you what I call is Pentagon of Profit Making. These are five pillars or five parts of the Pentagon. And if you master these five, you will make profits. And this is not published in any book so far. So my concept. So I'm going to share with you in detail all these 5 points. Homework number, what's the homework number? I lost the count. Three. Homework number three for all of you. Try to read or research more in the light of Pentagon of Profit Making. Five elements. Research for next 100 days. Research for economy, industry. I'm going to touch upon these points in more detail in a few minutes. Yes, sir? Yes, I will discuss that. I'm going to discuss that. If you ask my opinion, that's the most powerful pillar from this. But anyway, all are equally powerful. But this is my choice. So first is economy. You all know that. Previous slide, please. Okay. I'm mindful of the watch, okay? Perfect, we are on track. See, we need to look at economy parameters. We need to look at where is the economy growing. But then, how do you decide whether economy is growing or not? That depends upon which newspaper are you reading. Which TV channel are you following? Yes or no? Have you noticed that? Especially in India, one channel will say India is growing very fast, and one channel will say, oh, there's a lot of problems. Have you noticed that? What should you do? You know what? The best way, on the remote control, there's a red button. Switch it off. Seriously, I'm going to talk about in detail about the concept of noise, what I call is a noise. Look at Government of India's economic statistics. That is called economic survey. I think it is published already. So look at economic survey, look at GDP, look at capital intensive projects coming in, look at how much foreign institutional investors are coming in. Don't rely on some advertised TV journalist to tell you how you should invest. Ask him or her, how much have you invested? Ask him or her, do you know how to read a balance sheet? Are you getting me, class? So don't rely on TV channels, or I'm not against TV channels like that. Any journalist in this room? Brilliant, we are in safe zone now, good. Point is, I'm not against all the TV channels, but I'm against the idea of the concept, what I call is noise. There is all fluff going on, no major information coming that we can use it from tomorrow. If you start using five aspects of Pentagons of profit making from tomorrow, in next 100 days, you will see positive results. So first is look at economy. Also look at political ideology. Now different countries have different political ideology. And especially with the current government, all referring about the concept of development, economic development, foreign institutional investor, lot of big things are happening. Now you don't have to become political to understand political ideology. Are you with me? You don't need to have your personal opinion for any political party in favor or against to become an investor. Someone who is an expert in political party's ideology, that person will go and have a 2.5 hour seminar at Panka Galla. But someone who understands political ideology and use it for personal investment, that person becomes a smart investor. So I hope you are not wanting to convert all your political knowledge to have a free seminar at the junction, crossroad. You want to use that knowledge for your own personal benefit. Geography, many countries, you know, geography and topography. Many countries have different geographies and topography. Look at what kind of stock market prices happening in terms of product like tea, coffee. What kind of stock market prices are happening in the field of mining? Because certain country, certain state, certain city have a different geographical structure. And therefore, certain type of business like mining or tea or coffee that can happen big time in those cities or countries, but not everywhere. And subculture, look at the social culture. Currently, if you understand, if you look at Indian economy, the whole shift is happening on middle income group people. Because middle income group is the people who have got a lot of money. Because rich people, they have money, but they will buy assets. Middle income people have got money, they will buy expenses. They will spend money. So large number of consumer goods products are growing faster and faster and faster. Have you noticed that last 10 years? Be it eatables, be it consumer products like automobiles, tires, batteries. These are the sectors that are growing big time. Why? Because they have the products that are consumed by middle class again and again and again. You know what happened to Warren Buffett? Warren Buffett went to a restaurant and he ordered for a sandwich. And he wanted to have a ketchup. The guy brought a ketchup, he put a ketchup. Few days later, few months later, he went to some another place, some another restaurant. Again, he ordered for a sandwich. He wanted ketchup, he ordered for ketchup, got a ketchup. He noticed that every time I go to restaurant, every time I go to eat something, and whenever I ask for ketchup, I only get one ketchup bottle called Heinz ketchup. Now, I'm not, by the way, advertising hands here, okay? But I'm not wanting to encourage that. But I want to give you a real example what I learned from that. What he did? He bought majority shares of Hans Ketchum. You don't need to read balance sheet, profit and loss account, cash flow statement, technical analysis, candlestick charting, RSI. I was not talking in Sanskrit for a few minutes ago. These are all mathematical models that many financial management experts have created out of it. Ask yourself, what is your Hans Ketchum? You got my question? Can you find Hans Ketchum? Where are you going? Where do you spend time? What do you see most all the time? Keep your eyes and ears open. What do you see? Which products, which companies, which sectors, they are always there everywhere. Good idea to buy shares of that company.
Today it is Patanjali.
Today is Patanjali.
Everywhere you see.
But my next point was also sustainable. I was also referring to sustainable. So sustainable is how long? Yeah? But yeah, I agree with your point. Social culture is very important. How our whole society is moving. Previously, in a typical family, nuclear family, husband-wife family, only husband used to work, wife used to stay at home and everything. Now what is happening? Last 10 years, what is happening? Both are working. Because double income is important because we want to buy iPhone 10. Right? That's the thing. So now imagine what kind of products or services will be required to a housewife if she wants to be efficient in managing home as well as job. Think. Visitor, yeah. So think of those companies which has got products and services which can be offered to those housewives. Are you getting me? I'm trying to help you with the understanding we need to develop on how to spot things, how to spot a trend.
Home appliances,
yeah. So follow the companies of ready-made food, follow the companies of home appliances. Now start reading balance sheet, profit and loss account, cash flow statement of those companies.
Online shopping,
yeah. Second, industry. Industry is critical success factor, very important. Yeah? Every industry has a critical success factor. Software IT has got a critical success factor of manpower, people. Or visa rules and regulations. If American visa rules and regulations become tight, TCS and Wipro will go down. Infosys will go down. There's an earthquake in Taiwan, shares of HP will go down. Because Taiwan is a country which makes most of the computer chips. So we need to understand which industry has got critical success factor. What are the competition and competitive advantage? Is this having a product which has got competition? We need to find out. What are the industry trade barriers? Who can enter, who cannot? And in many cases, there are professional bodies who have got a lot of bargaining power. 5,000 people will go to the factory because there's a pollution and there's a factory ban karo. Have you seen that on TV? Environment implications. Your all stock market prices will go down. I'll give you one international example. I don't want to make it too much of Indian as well. Is there's a company in UK listed on London Stock Exchange. The name of the company is TalkTalk. T-A-L-K, TalkTalk. It's a basically landline phone, mobile phone, internet, broadband, everything. Very good company, and excellent profit making, growing every year. Every year the company is growing 3 to 4% per year. Now on London Stock Exchange, if a company is growing 3% to 4% per year, it is best company. Because the whole economy is growing 1% per year. And this company is growing 3 to 4% per year. Happy? One fine day, at morning 10:30, the company's share price went down by 22%. One day. 22% down. You know why? A 14-year-old Irish boy, Irish is Ireland. Ireland is like Saurashtra of Gujarat, a different section, same state. 14-year-old kid, 14-year young kid, Irish kid, hacked the website of TalkTalk. And put the banner, TalkTalk is not working, it's a rubbish website. 14-year-old guy. Police took 6 months to find out who was the person who hacked it. After 6 months, they found there was a 14-year-old boy who did this. Of course, he was being interrogated. Of course, he was punished. But what happened to companies' market capitalization? 22% down in one day. Company has not grown 22% in 5 years. One day, wipe off. I don't want to give you another examples of another companies that starts with F and ends with K, because there are many other words in English language which can have different meaning with same alphabets, which has happened in last month. Point is, what can happen is about the trade association's bargaining power. One person can turn around your company like this. And when this 14-year-old boy for Talk Talk was interviewed and asked, why the hell you did this? Kyun karyo? He said, I was just checking out whether I can do this or not. See, this is the real example. So your analysis of balance sheet profit loss account can be great, but you cannot control a 14-year-old boy. Anyone 14-year-old in the class, in the room? Oh, good, we are in safe zone, good. Company, always analyze the company. What I do specifically for my clients is I look at the company's historic background. When was it started? Who is the promoter? Very important, executive leadership. When I say executive leadership, I mean chairman, CEO, director. Who are they? What kind of products and services they offer? And what is the market potential? Have you all seen the movie, Hollywood movie called Duplicity? Anyone seen that movie, Duplicity? Great. Homework number four. You need to watch the movie, Duplicity. Wall Street is again a very, very good movie. Very good movie. Duplicity. Nice star cast. You'll enjoy that movie, Brad Pitt, if you like Brad Pitt. All focusing on competition, all focusing on what kind of products and services they are offering. There are corporate detectives whose full-time job is to spy on CEOs. Morning to evening, what do? They spy CEOs. There are detectives who just follow where CEO is going, where CEO is having a discussion, have a meeting. And based on that, they make a judgment of what will be the impact on stock market price. Right? Duplicity movie. And obviously, we need to understand brand and reputation. Obviously, these are all known facts. A company which has got a higher brand value will have a higher stock market price value. Right? Company which has got a lower brand value or lower reputation, the share prices will not grow much. We all know that. Wow, that was awesome. Can we do it again, please? Who was that? Okay. Balance sheet, profit and loss account, and cash flow statement. Have you heard about these three giants? We need to master that. And in the workshop on 3 days, I'm going to direct and I'm going to actually show the balance sheet and how to analyze it, how to read it, and I'm going to help you to analyze it. Because the workshop, there are two rules. One is you need to bring your laptop, and second is you need to be present during all the 3 days, during those times. You can't miss one session. So on your laptop, I'm going to show you how you can work it for your balance sheet, profit loss account, and cash flow. And then there are some mathematical models. We call it ratios. There are different types of ratios. Could be current ratio or acid test ratio, return on capital employed, return on investments. Now these are all formula driven ratios. Good news, last 10 years, all these ratios are freely available on Google. Right? Otherwise we had to calculate it. But I'm going to show you how to calculate, just in case your Google is not working. I'm going to show you how to calculate it in the training program. And technical analysis, again, a very, very important science. There are two different science. One is called fundamental analysis and one is called technical analysis. Fundamental analysis is the science of looking at balance sheet, profit loss account, and cash flow statement. And technical analysis is a science of looking at charts. You know, graph price movement. How can we look at the chart price movement and predict the share price? That's called technical analysis. Again, we are going to discuss in detail about technical analysis. Very important is, I was just referring to the chart, is the trend. What is a mega trend happening? I already told you. As far as Indian economy is concerned, the growth is the trend. Middle income group, middle class is a huge trend. Software IT is great, but anything that helps middle class is going to be a huge, huge path breaker trend. Another trend is happening in terms of social profiling. There's a very nice book called Business at the Speed of Thought, author Bill Gates, wherein he mentioned about this 20 years ago, that when you go to a restaurant or you order for a pizza at home, because now they know your address, they're going to tell you what pizza did you order for home delivery last time. That's called social profiling. They are monitoring your consumption pattern. They are monitoring what kind of choices you are making. In Holiday Inn hotel, they monitor what kind of pillow you like to sleep. And they could give you soft pillow or hard pillow dependent upon what's your next day morning schedule. There's a wardrobe of 12 pillows for customers. And on that basis, they make a judgment, what kind of quality will you like it. So social profiling is happening big time. Can I give you an example of social profiling in this room? Just simple question. How many of people in the room are with spectacles? See around. No, you all see around. I can see. You all see around. How many people are from... That's called social profiling. Are you with me? So people with spectacles, people without spectacles. Now the product consumption for people with spectacles could be different. So think that way. So when you read a newspaper and when you see, oh, the population of people with spectacles is increasing, now you know what product or what services demand will go up. That's your hand sketchup. So find out hand sketchup. That's your another homework. What is hand sketchup for you? I mean, don't bring a red bottle for me, okay, next time. I hope you understood what I mean by example of hand sketchup. Of course, we all know technology is growing big time. Of course, we know the concept of privacy is a big deal. We all know Cambridge Analytica. We all have read the newspaper. We all know that. And this was happening a few years ago already. In fact, 3 years ago, I did a conference in London, and I said that if anything, coincidentally, this statement is coming up in some newspaper now. Is anything for free is actually you are the product. Now, this is very, very common sense, very, very, you know, but if you look at it, all these corporate companies are debating between individualism and collectivism. There's a whole philosophy and social science about the countries and society being collectivist society. For example, India is a collectivist society. We like to live in group, we like to spend time in together. But these big multinational companies, they don't like it. So they want to divide you, all of you, instead of having a collection of people, they want to deal with you as individual. There is a whole big science by big corporate companies. I call it conspiracy. And I call it corporate terrorism. There is a huge corporate terrorism happening since last 50 years, not 5 years, 50 years. The whole corporate terrorism is working to divide the society. Instead of collectivism, they divide you as individual. Why? If you have a TV in the room, you all will sit together and watch TV in the room. Yes or no? But four people in the family, all four of you have got a mobile phone, who will sit in the room? Dividing people. Are you getting me? It's a very, very thin, minor, subliminal undercurrent going on. If you have to be very strong in observing, it's like when there's earthquake, cockroaches will come out first because they can look at the vibration, not human beings. We need to be very sensitive to look at that vibrations. Last 50 years, the corporate terrorist activity is happening. And in fact, I think some time ago when we did, in fact, my topic was this, corporate terrorism itself, that what I remember. So be mindful of the fact about individualism versus collectivism and religion and culture. The whole idea of religion and culture is not to pay respect to your religion or to your culture. No, religion and culture is a huge business. You know that? You don't like it? You didn't like what I said? Religion and culture is a huge business. Large number of companies are targeting specific religion based products and services. Yes or no? Have you noticed that? You please notice for next 100 days about this, what I talk, okay? You don't need to agree with me right now. And most important, world's number one business. What is the world's number one business? Religion and culture is number two. Number one, world's number one business. World's number one business is war. Is war. Yeah, arms and ammunition. Right? So look at that perspective. So it's up to you. Now, fifth and the last strategy for all of you, or pentagon of profit making, the fifth one, is our subconscious mind. Now, mind can be your master, mind can be your servant. There are two kinds of people. One is called reactive, and another is called proactive. Anything happens, they have instant reaction. These are called reactive people. They wait for something happen and suddenly they react. Imagine if there is a siren going on, oh, we'll all see, oh, what's that? Someone's mobile phone just had a very nice whistle and we were all looking at it. We were all becoming reactive. Did you notice that? Wow, see? Right? So, most important point is, don't be reactive, be proactive. Yes, sir.
Sir, I would like to give you my suggestion.
Sure.
Regarding previous
sure.
In trade, you have mentioned religious and culture.
Yeah.
Add more spiritual.
Of course, yeah. More. Makes sense. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Good idea. So reactive and proactive. Can we become proactive? Before anything happens, can we develop a sense of what is going to happen, and thereby we are taking steps? We don't need to wait for the finance minister to declare budget and now we decide, okay, where do we invest? Right? We could become proactive. Identify your hands catch up. Find out your hands catch up. That's the key. That's the key for today. Lot of noise is happening. What is meaning of noise? Noise means distraction. Noise means temptation. Noise means irrelevant extra information which is not needed. Most of the investors, they spend less time in learning and researching, but they spend more time in noise. 24 hours TV channel talking about stock market, one after another. In my humble and accurate opinion, is called noise. Why Warren Buffett and Charlie Munger, they don't live near New York Stock Exchange? They live 4,000 kilometers away from New York Stock Exchange. Not 50 kilometers away. 4,000 kilometers, they live in Texas. Right? So point is, you need to understand carefully, is avoid noise. What is your noise? What is your noise in your life? I don't know. I don't look at you every 24 hours. Identify what noise you have in your life. Any disturbance happening which is not keeping your mind powerful, which is not protecting your subconscious mind. Always remember, don't take too much information on stock market from so many different sources. I got a friend of mine, he's got 12 magazines and 10 newspapers on stock market. Spend 15 hours a day on TV. And look at his life, look at his family, everything is messed up. Over-information load is going to destroy you. You don't need 20 transactions a month. You need 20 transactions a year. Life. Less is more. If you like one newspaper, if you like one research article, Just focus on that. That's it. Or maybe two. Multiple apps downloaded on mobile phone. How many of you have got apps? Mobile phone apps? Money control app, ICICI app. So many apps. Smart investor app, whatnot. Morningstar, anyone Morningstar? Morningstar? Nobody? By the way, it's a cool app, Morningstar. Oh, you're in Morningstar. Wow, same like me. Morningstar is another good app. We are going to discuss about those apps and everything in the training program in more detail. But point is, less is more. Can you remove unnecessary noise from your schedule, from your mobile, from your email, from your... Too much information going in your brain is not good. And remember, stock market is all about human emotions. And we are dealing with greed, fear, and ego. These are the three emotions. In fact, it's part of ego. Ego is a larger umbrella we all have. And there are different facets of ego. One of the facets is called greed. When the company share price is going up and up, what do we say? Arre ajit to vadse, bechta nahi. Yes or no? Right? Greed. Or fear. Right? Darija, right? But these are, fear and greed are actually a reflection of our own ego. How do we treat ourselves? Can we identify our own greed, fear, ego? Your homework number 6. Next 100 days, when you're looking at it, when you're trading, when you're buying shares, selling shares, are you doing out of scientific principles or are you doing because of your fear? Ask yourself. Are you doing this because of your greed? Some people become overconfident. Mane to chane jara pan ego j nathi. Have you heard that? Exactly. That itself. We all have ego and we should, but identify. Most magical moment is, have some silence in your life. Half an hour a day, 20 minutes a day. Do some mindfulness or yoga or prayers, whatever you like, but do it. Because if your mind is not stable, all balance sheet, profit and loss account, technical analysis, tips will never work. Somebody will give you a tip. Some bald-headed guy in Ahmedabad Management Association in the evening will come and tell you, do this. But because you have a lot of fear, you will not do it for next 100 days. Oh, that guy gave me some 6-7 homework. I'm like a school kid or what? I don't want to do this 100 days. That's ego. Why not? Let me try. Trial room. Nothing is going to lose. Right? So do that. Meditation, prayer, self-talk. Right? How to handle success? If you make some money in stock market, wow. How do you handle it? The best way to handle success is to teach others how to become successful. Best method. And how to handle failure? Learn why you failed and try again. Not just to be failing and then be upset and sad about it and then, oh, I'm going to leave it. I'm going to quit. Don't do that. So I'm about to conclude now. These are the two books I would recommend all of you to buy. Right? The book is Intelligent Investor by Benjamin Graham and Warren Buffett's Financial Statements Analysis. Right? These two books must be there in your library within next 100 days. And do you want this PowerPoint presentation for free? Yes. You can download this. You can go to my personal website, jatinpancholi.com. And see the right hand side box like this. Can you see the yellow color thing? Sign up to email update. If you click on sign up to email update, put your name and email ID. In 24 to 48 hours, in reply email, you will get this PowerPoint presentation. Is that cool? Sure. Book is this. Yeah. And why these books are very, very important is, you know, Warren Buffett's professor, because Warren Buffett learned everything from his professor, his teacher. His teacher, his professor's name is Benjamin Graham, Columbia Business School in USA. This is the book, Columbia Business School, Professor Benjamin Graham, The Intelligent Investor. This is the book. So first learn from Guru and then learn from the man. These two books, very important, right? So go to my website, put your name and email ID. And in 48 hours, you will get an email with the downloading, with the PowerPoint file. And also look at the research paper. You know, books are not enough. There are some research papers where people have done research of a lot of data. So I'm giving you Nobel Prize winning two researches by another person whom I'm following and admiring called Eugene Fama. And these research papers are published in the year 1965 and 1970. Anyone, that's not a good question. I was asking anyone born before 1965. There are so many people born. That's not my question. But these two research papers, again, very, very good for you to understand the basics, right? And I know it's very difficult for you to write down. You can take a photo. But best is put your email ID on my website and you'll get email. And I'm also doing free webinar. Are you aware what is webinar? Webinar is basically your video conferencing system, and I do 30 to 45 minutes webinar, followed by 15 to 30 minutes question and answer session. You can attend the webinar sitting at home. I usually do webinars for free on Sunday, not this Sunday, okay? And the schedule is announced 1 month in advance. And you and your friends, family, you can all attend, free for all. You don't need to pay any money, and you can attend live on your computer, on laptop, or tablet with good quality internet connection. You cannot attend this on mobile phone, because I have noticed mobile phone people, they get disconnected. So get a good quality laptop, good quality internet, and join. How many of you want to register for future free webinars? Right. What do you do? You again visit my personal website and register your name and email ID. On the right-hand side box, sign up for email update. So next time when there's a webinar happening in the month of May, you will get an invitation. So with this, I'm done. Thank you very much. And these are my email address. Yeah. If you have any questions, feel free to email.
Just gentlemen, I'll just take 1 minute, if you can be seated. Just gratitude to our speaker. We've had a wonderful evening, I said investment, and very informative and enriching. And not only that, if you have noticed, a key attribute of this talk was more of a ethical and a holistic approach. Not necessarily the stock market, but you know, the things you mentioned about, you know, your greed, about your mindfulness, silence, that applies all across. So that was a good holistic approach to this method. So, and Jatin bhai, thank you very much. And on behalf of AM and the audience, Piyush bhai, can you come up and give a memento to Jatin bhai, please?
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, wish you a very good evening. And after this talk, you had a small bonus of the PPT download from the website and other informative information. Once again, thank you very much, and I wish you a very good evening.
Thank you very much. Thank you.